everybody. This is your host, Angie, from Religion to Woohoo. And I don't know about you guys, but I am having a good day. It is Sunday here. And I have been trying to go on walks several times a week. And there's this really big hill near my house, like massive hill. And I have been like trying to get myself to like go and walk up and down it and walk, you know, kind of about 4 miles a couple times a week. And today I was trying to write my second book, and was just getting like blocks in my energy. And so I was like, I think I need to get up and move around and just release some stagnant energies. I did a couple Reiki sessions yesterday, and then spent some time with some family last night, and my energy's a little lower and drained today, and I slept in, and so I like had all these ideas of what I was going to get done today, but it just wasn't happening. So I decided to go out and move my body. I did not intend to go and hike on a trail, which I love hiking. I was just going to kind of stay on the main road like I had been doing. However, I got in my car and I was like, you know, I haven't ever been to this trail before. So I drove around the city to this trail. I did not have my hiking shoes on. And I will tell you, I will not be going hiking without my hiking shoes again, because I fell twice. Thankfully, I did not hurt myself. I do have some scrapes on my legs and arms, and then I did twist my ankle, but it does not hurt, thankfully, at this point. And so I only walked about a mile and a half on that trail, and then I went ahead and drove over to the other area I usually walk, and walked that for a little bit. And so I'm feeling some energy move now. We'll see what happens after this, but that's just something you guys can think about. Like, if you're really trying to get something to come out of you and you feel this stagnant energy, maybe get up and like move your body, do something, kind of let go of what you're trying to do, because then your mind can move back into that creative zone, and it's not so pressured to perform in a certain way. So as I'm walking, you know, I'm thinking about things I want to manifest, things I want to align into my energy, thinking about relationships in my life, thinking about just, you know, a lot's going through my mind. And I'm, you know, really trying to manifest my abundance and future and life calling, and just move into this, what I was meant to do. And I believe everybody has this. Everybody has a purpose. Everybody has a reason for being on earth, because of programming, because of beliefs, because of what we're taught in our society and culture and families and the people we surround ourselves with, the cities, whatever. We tend to take our mind that is actually connected to the universal abundance and limit it and put it in this little box. And we think inside of this box that this is the way we do life. This is how we can live. And these are the steps to do it. And so for most adults, that is working a job that you can pay your bills. That means once in a while finding time to spend time with friends if you can. Most adults that have children or work full-time, they don't even have time to do that. If you have kids, making sure that your kids are places they need to be, that they're in the sports they, you know, what they want to do, or maybe you want them to do. And we kind of start to develop this stagnant lifestyle that is just like go, 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 one thing to the next. And then we don't even think about anything outside of that, because that is what we program our minds. And we believe that is it's almost like we convince ourselves that this is our successful life. This is the life that we're going to live. And then it's almost, we also start to live our lives in alignment with what other people around us want as well. So, in our job, our performance is based on what we can provide to the company we work for. In the family, our performance is based on how we provide for the family or how we take care of them. So it's always about what we're doing for somebody else. And what it really takes to manifest a life aligned with your highest self is to get in touch with your own consciousness. So stepping out of this subconscious programming of just performing and going through life without even thinking about what you're doing. You're just doing it because you have to. Like, it's just a automatic, like, I have to go to work. I have to get the kids here. I have to do this. I have to do that. And, you know, I understand a lot of things you probably do have to do because that's just how the world works. However, I wonder how many things we do because we think we have to, or because it just is a natural thing to do. I think about how when people have downtime, the first thing they think about doing is, I mean, you're going to have anything from TV, going out to a bar with friends. You know, some people really enjoy, you know, being in the yard. I don't know. There's going to be all kinds of things that you do. And none of that is bad. None of it is bad. But what happens is when we start to see and we look around us and we see people that are, that seem to be doing big things in what we consider to be big, starting to change, starting to make influence, starting to build a life that you're kind of like, oh, wow, that's, you know, I wonder how she's doing that. I think about, like, people that are in the public eye. Like, I think about Oprah a lot. Like, how does she build herself into this person that the entire world knows? Or people like Brene Brown. How did she build herself into this person the entire world knows? And then you have other people like Joe Dispenza. And you have other people like Jay Shetty. And you have, you know, all these influencers who are out there that have these names that people know. Like, you say them and people are like, oh, I know who that is, or I've read a book by them, or I've seen them on YouTube, or I've watched this, or something comes up and you are like, yes, they are an influencer and they have good things today, and I listen to that, and I try to do that kind of a thing. And here's where it gets us, though. Our butt. We all have a butt full of shit. And this is what my spirit guys told me when I was on a walk today. And I was like, oh my gosh, that's so good. And my spirit guides were like, yep, we know. And so, but I heard, we all have a butt full of shit. It's not until you release the shit that you can clear things out so that you can begin to understand and align with what your true authentic self is. So I'm not talking about an actual going to the bathroom moment. I'm talking about getting the shit out of your mind. All the buts that we have that come up. But this, but that, but this. We're always going to have a but. And usually behind the but is some kind of a shitty thinking. Where we start to think, I can't, but I can't because, but this is this way, but this. There's always going to be a butt full of shit that will follow any excuse. You can say, you know, I could do this, but I have this. So how many buts are you letting get in the way of moving forward into your life and aligning your energy into who you are authentically, truly made to be in your soul purpose? What kind of shit is behind your butt that keeps you stuck? What's keeping you constipated? Let's just put it that way. Like, my spirit guides gave me the message. I'm just going to put it out. What is keeping you stuck from flowing in abundant energy? You know, I was talking to a client the other day that I've been working with for probably a little over a month or two, probably 2 months now. And it's always interesting to see from the outside perspective somebody else grow. And usually you don't see your own growth because you're focused on all of your shitty butts. like all of the things that, but I still have this and I still have to do this. And this is not where I want it to be. And like all these things are not where you want them to be because you're focused on all the butts. However, when I look at this client and I see her life, I see a transformation. I see a mindset that is moving into a new thinking. And what we were talking about earlier this week when I was doing a coaching session with her, she was not feeling good. And, you know, she was talking about lack mindset and such. And I'll be 100% honest. This is something I work on too, because of my trauma I came out of, like, I am having to retrain my brain to not think in lack. And, you know, I was just like, and this is something my spirit had put in me a while back, is love heals everything. I truly believe that. And when we're aligned with the highest energy of love, and we send love out into all things, into all of our negative thinking, into our programmed mind, into all this stuff, we align our energy with receiving more of that. When we put out the positive mindsets, we receive more positive. And so I was telling her about, I said, you know, embrace the pennies. Embrace every small moment that you get that is aligned with your higher self. Because the more you embrace the pennies turn into more. And we look past all the small things we do in growth. We look past all the small things that are going well. Because we think it all has to be lumped into one big sum of success and abundance. It has to look the way that we think it took Oprah, Brene Brown, Jay Shetty, Joe Dispenza. We think they just got there. We just have this mindset of they are just there. And therefore, they are the ones that are going to influence us to live our small little lives, maybe a little bit better. And so we keep ourselves small and we have all these buts with this shitty thinking behind it that keep us stuck, without realizing that all the tiny little things that are going well around us are the ways we align with our energy. And like I told my client the other day, I go, I love my vehicle. So I bought a Jeep a year and a half ago. It's not the Jeep I want. I have a specific kind I want, and one day I'm gonna get it. I am manifesting it. However, the Jeep I have right now is a 2017. It's the newest car I've ever had. I am paying for it myself. I got a loan. Everything just lined up perfectly for it. I pay a lot for this Jeep every month, more than I've ever paid for any other vehicle. And technically, according to my bank account, I probably shouldn't have this. I should, like, according to the energy I've had in my money mindset, I should not have enough money to keep this vehicle. However, I do. And I'm going to continue to have it because I'm appreciating what I have. I am so thankful that I have credit cards that help me get by when I need them. I'm thankful for the money I get to borrow from these sources. I'm thankful for my Jeep. I love my Jeep. I love the money in my bank account. I love my home. You have to align with the small little things. And those may not seem small, but compared to the things that you do desire, They are. So when you align with the small things, you start to attract other things. So embracing the pennies will then bring in the dollars, and the dollars will bring in the $10, and the $10 will bring in the 20, and a 20 into, you know, it just keeps going. You get up to 1,000 and 10,000, 20,000. Like, just allow yourself to love where you are. If you don't love the moment now, you're not going to love where you get, even if you did. That's why so many people win the lottery and they end up right back where they are, because they don't love where they are now. They don't appreciate the small things now. There's always something they can find that's not right or not going the way they want them to go. Instead of embracing the pennies, being thankful they can pay what the bills are they can pay now, they are not able to move into this abundant mindset, even if they get it. So the practice starts now. The practice starts where you are. And to allow all of your butts and all the shitty thinking in your butts to turn into a positive, abundant, flowing mindset, and moving into the freedom that our spirit lives in all the time. Our spirit is connected to the universe, the entire universe. There is nothing lacking in the universe. Nothing. You know, there's that saying, and I've heard this many times, like, a bird doesn't freak out about where it can build a nest, where its next food source is going to come from, where, you know, how it's going to survive. It just lives. It lives its life knowing that the universe is always going to supply what it needs. It's always going to give what it needs. And we have to think that. Understanding that we are not immortal. We are not. The next moment we have, we are going to have a blessing to have it. Tomorrow is a blessing because today is all we have. So when we align with our energy today and we are blessed with tomorrow, and the universe gives us tomorrow in this human form that we're in, then we get to move into that next day with the abundance mindset that we carried into the day we are in now. And it builds on each other. And because truly, our spirit never ever, our spirit is eternal. Our spirit is immortal. Our body, our flesh is not. In our spirit, there is always enough. So when we are completely aligned with this energy, with our spirit self, there's no reason to have all the buts, because we understand that in the universal energy, in the abundant mindset, in the spirit realm, there's no shitty thinking. There's none. And so all the things that you have in your mind, whether it came from religious programming, whether it came from the culture you live in, whether it came from the fact that you didn't grow up in a family that had much, or whatever it is that your mindset is struggling with right now, you have the ability to change it. And I fully believe that you have to align with your whole being and your whole spirit and connect with your consciousness to get to this point. And that's through allowing your mind to reprogram, to step back, manifest through meditation, through aligning your energy, through appreciating the small things. Embrace the penny. Embracing the pennies of your life. So that is what I was receiving today in my spirit. And I am going to align myself with this as well. I encourage you to do so. And if you want help with this, I am still developing this program that I said I was going to, this group coaching, or I'm going to call it a mentorship, I guess. I'm not so sure I like the coaching name, because I do feel more of so like as if I'm supposed to mentor or teach. And so if you feel aligned with that, I'm going to try to get this together within the next few weeks and get this out there so that we can all work on this mindset together to get all of our butts and all of our shitty thinking out of the way. Okay. All right. So again, thank you so much for spending time with me today. Thank you for taking the time out for yourself. I hope that this helps you as you move forward. And as always, I am here if you need to reach out. Just send me an email on my website. And if you want to do one-on-one work with me, if you want to just talk about something to see if there's something I can do to help, let me know. Also, don't forget to purchase my book. It's on Amazon. It's called Leaf Lessons. And I promise you that it will be encouraging and it will help you to move forward. So I wish you all the best day, night, evening, whatever time it is. I send you all the universal love. Namaste.